Dear friends, we're happy to greet you on our 13th Come Together session. As usual, we've prepared an interesting program for you. On the Day of Europe today, to see the diversity of Europe, actually, in our program. The session is organized by Emilia Velikova from University of Ruse, our dear partner, and I will give her the moderation from now on, and have fun.
Thank you very much, Victoria. Thank you very much. Today is 9th of May, the Europe Day. On this day, every year, we celebrate peace and unity in Europe. The date marks the establishment in Paris in 1950, a new form of political cooperation in Europe, which would make war between Europe's nations unthinkable. This day gives us possibilities to share knowledge, culture, languages, to be together in bad and happy times. Let's be good friends, neighbors, partners, colleagues. So now we can continue with our program. To explain the program, the first we start with Lazarus Day, performance by the theater group Hoptrop. These children who are here from Bulgaria, Slivopole municipality. After that, we will see the song The Lonely Boat, a Hungarian song presented by Barbara Sicho, professional singer. She is a student at school, but she is a very good singer. After that, we will see Timișoara of Yesterday and Today, a presentation by Mirela Carp. Timișoara, Romania. The song Three Evenings on the Danube, a Bulgarian song by a performance by Yordanka Ilieva and the orchestra Choro Ruse Bulgaria. Tarlisu and Bumbasina, The Triangle of Culture, Economy and Art, presentation by Farnas Taer Shems. From Italy, the University of Third Age, Castellanza, Italy. After that, I Grow Up Along the Danube, a Serbian song of Zvonko Bogdan, performance by Tatjana Petrica, Vršac, Serbia. And we finish with another song, Angel in the Morning, a song of Jewish Newton, performance by Larry Gnocchi, Ulm, Germany. The program is very nice, will be music, good performance. So let's start.
Yes, let us start. Emily, thank you for leading the presentation of participants. And I would like to introduce the first contribution. We have seen a little teaser, a little trailer last time in the session, who was there with Mrs. Erla. And we got really curious about the Laza Day, that is an important holiday in Bulgaria. And right now we even have the actors with us, the group of children. And I think they're very excited to see them performing. And we will show the whole version of video and we will make stops so Emilia can explain what is happening for us because it's in Bulgarian. And maybe also they want to say a couple of words afterwards, how it was to make this play. So we're very excited. Emily, please start.
Oh, this is educational theater. Usually this is a combination between elderly persons and young generations, but now is only from young persons. So let's start. Can you see my monitor?
Yes.
Okay. Lazarus Day. Lazarus Den, Lazaritsa, Lazarus Day. It is the day of Saint Lazar. It is also an old Bulgarian tradition, a celebration of the nature and of a young girl, known as Lazarki, who after this day are allowed to date, getting judged, and consequently get married. After the celebration, Lazarki go to the Danube and gives their wreaths to the river. It is a competition. Which wreath will be the first? This girl will be the leader of the Lazarus Day in the next year. And will be the first to marry. The municipality of Slivopole, Bulgaria, especially the mayor, Valentin Atanasov, supports the activities of all generations, such as the Union of Pensioners with 700 members, 11 cultural communities, the theater, youth group, Hoptrop, etc. In this drama game that you see, the young girl are carrying a basket of eggs. They tour the village, going into every house and singing a song for every member of the family. If it is a little girl or boy, then it is a song with a wish for good health. If it is a young man, to have a family. So the girls going in house with the song, tulip swings on a green meadow. It is not a tulip, it is a child. So let's start video. Songs are about the tradition. One girl shows that like one boy if she gives him water to drink. So this is information in the song. After that, the girls are singing another song because in this house there is a child and they dance in a circle. And the song is a child is asleep in a gilded swing. His mother wakes him. Get up, baby. To see Lazarki, how to skirt flooded, yellow slipper top. So, Pari, put the next part, please.
Хайде, ама да поберем с Лазарки. Хайде, ама. Да. Я се смела.
The girls make wishes. As much geranium in the forest, as many health at home, which is very important in the COVID-19 times. As much sons in the river, as many children at home. After that, according to another tradition, the householder gives to the girls bread with honey. Geraniums and iron coins. This is for success, health, and luck. She also gives them white eggs, which they have to die on Monday, Tuesday, or Holy Saturday, and never on Good Friday before the Easter. The first eggs should be red for the joy of the soul. The second should be yellow, for golden grains. The third should be green for lush meadow, and all other colorful for colorful gardens. Yes. Tari, put the next part, please.
Благодарим ви, Лазарки. Сега да ви дарим пипка и мед за здраве и беритет. Всеки да се вземе, да се
очупи, да се напи.
The holder says, let's roll the sieve to see what the year will be like. If it is with the hole up, the year will be good for health and rich. You will see, unfortunately, the sieve will be not hole up. And it is obviously that our year 2021 will be bad. So, Пари, put this part and we'll finish.
Да търгувам ситото, за да видим какво ще е годината. Ако е с отворена горе, ще бъде пълна. Ако е вътре, ще бъде празна.
It is not good.
И в това ще да сме живи и здрави.
Да, да сте здрави.
So, they say that we will be in good health, And after that, they say thank you very much and go to another house singing tulip swings on a green meadow. It is not a tulip, it is a child. So thank you very much, girls, for this educational theater that keep traditions for all generations.
This guy is talking. Maybe we can ask the girls about.
Чудесні лазерки.
Can we say a couple of words, Emily, about the performance?
They say that they are beautiful lazarki, beautiful children.
Can they say something, the children? I mean,
Pari, can you show the girls?
In the video, you mean?
Yes, they are there. I see them. Yes.
In the spot.
But they are muted. They cannot.
They will open, but I
can. No,
cannot.
No.
Show them.
Very show them in the spotlight.
Yes, they
thank
are
you. Spotlight. We are happy to take part in this conference and to show Bulgarian old traditions.
It was very, very beautiful. You're amazing. Very good.
Do you have got other games? Other theaters?
Yes, we have a dance formation called Hop Drop and also boys participate in it. And we are showing traditional Bulgarian dances all around Bulgaria. And we hope to take part in competitions in Europe, for example.
Ah, bravo, bravo.
So maybe you can also present at the next session something or in future another play. We will be really glad.
Boys and girls. Some dancing.
Of course, we will be happy to take part again.
We also will be happy to see you again. Thank you very much, girls. You are very, very beautiful, very clever to do this. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a nice evening.
Okay, let's continue now with the song of the Lonely Boat. This is Hungarian. Her girl, Barbara Svichu, and she prepared two videos because she has never part in such kind of conference and was very worried about this participation. So, Pari, please show the video.
Hi, I'm Svichu Barbara, I'm 18, and I live in Romania, although I'm Hungarian. I'm a student at Mihai Eminescu High School, and today I will be singing my favorite song in Hungarian, Magányos csónak by Tompos Kátya, which means The Lonely Boat. I love this song very much because it's about fighting every battle you have to reach your dreams. So young people, keep up the good work, because I believe in you. I hope you will like this song too. Have a nice evening. I'm sending love.
What a nice message. We're excited for the song.
Mozdulni vége,
Thank you very much. Bravo. Bravo, she's only 18 years old, but is professional, obviously. We hope, we wish her success in the future. So we continue with Romanian presentation of Mirela Karp, Timișoara of yesterday and today.
Se vede, doamna Ana, da?
Da, da, perfect.
Perfect. Prin urmare, plimbare prin Timișoara de ieri și de azi. Timișoara este unul dintre cele mai mari orașe din România. Situată în sud-estul câmpiei Tisei, Timișoara este centrul cultural și economic al zonei de vest, reședința județului Timiș și capitala provinciei istorice Banat.
Timișoara is one of the largest cities in Romania. Located in the southeast of the Tisa Plain, Timișoara is the cultural and economic center of the western area, the residence of Timiș County and the capital of the historic province of Banat.
Oraș cu ritm de viață calm, cumva răspândind un aer de tihnă mic burghetineală, parcă mereu rezervându-ne surpriza unei noi întâlniri, fie prin cine știe ce eveniment, ori sărbătoare, și chiar prin popularele ritualuri profane, fie prin propria sa înfățișare arhitecturală.
As a city with a calm pace of life, breathing an air of petit bourgeois leisure, Timișoara reveals itself a little at a time, as if always keeping in reserve the surprise of some new encounter, either through who knows what event or celebration, or through its own architectural appearance.
Dacă ar fi să facem o plimbare prin Timișoara cu intenția de a descoperi, de a ne fixa în memorie și în cele din urmă de a ne încânta ochii cu varietatea de stiluri arhitecturale, am începe probabil cu o plimbare prin Piața Victoriei.
If we were to take a walk through Timișoara with the intention of discovering, fixing in our memory and finally delighting our eyes, we would probably begin with a stroll through Victory Square.
Impunătoarea construcție a Teatrului Național și a Operei Române, care a suferit în lungul timpului câteva metamorfoze arhitecturale, piața aliniază palatele construite între anii 1910 și 1913. Edificiul teatrului a fost construit în stilul renașterii italiene, după proiectele arhitecților vienezi Helmer și Fellner, clădirea incluzând și hotelul Kropnitz Rudolf, redenumit ulterior Hotelul Ferdinand.
You can see here the Palace of Culture, which has the Opera House and the National Theatre. They have gone through a number of architectural metamorphoses over time, but we can see that the theatre was built in the Italian Renaissance style by the designs of the architects Helmer and Fellner from Vienna. The building also included the Crown Prince Rudolf Hotel.
Palatul Lloyd, fost sediu al bursei agricole al societății Lloyd, cu restaurantul deschis către piață, prin spilcuita sa grădină de vară, aripa Lloyd devenită din anul 1948 Palat al Politehnicii.
You can see here the Lloyd Palace, which was the former office of the Agricultural Stock Exchange, and here the wing, the Lloyd wing, since 1948 became the Polytechnic Palace.
Ajunși în centrul pieței Victoriei, ne răcorim degetele în șuvoaiele subțiri de apă ce țâșnesc din gura de metal a peștilor lucitori și negri, ce fac parte din complexul fântânii arteziene cu pești, zidită în 1953. Pe aceeași axă ne dăm seama că am trecut pe lângă un monument timișorean de referință, dăruit Timișoarei de municipalitatea orașului Roma, o coloană înaltă de 5 metri ce susține replica lupoaicei, lupei Capitolina, tronând într-un careu de vegetare. Lupoaica, așa cum o știm, statuia lui Romulus și Remus, s-a dezvelit în data de 23 aprilie 1926, în prezența a peste 10.000 de persoane, la festivitate luând parte în numele guvernului, miniștrii de atunci ai cultelor și muncii, precum și consulul Șoara, cel care a oficiat predarea monumentului.
In the left side you can see the fish fountain. Aside, you can see one Timișoara monument, very famous, which is a copy of the Lupa Capitolina, and was a gift from the authorities of the city of Rome. The she-wolf, the statue of Romulus and Remus, was unveiled in April 1926 before of 10,000 people. Then the ministers of religion and labor were present on behalf of the government and also the Italian consul in Timișoara, which presented the monument.
Catedrala Ortodoxă Română, ctitoria regelui Mihai, a fost construită între anii 1936-1946, numită în mod obișnuit de timișoreni Catedrala Mitropoliei Banatului. Știm că a fost construită între aceștia ani după planurile arhitectului Traianescu, iar a fost pictată între anii 1939-1946, măsoară 63 de metri lungime, 32 de metri lățime, 83,7 de metri înălțime în dreptul turlei principale, pe care se înalță o cruce de 7 metri. De asemenea, mai știm că în interiorul bogat ornamentat al catedralei, în cap în timpul slujbelor, mai bine de 4.500 de persoane, iar fastuoasa ei alcătuire este, sub raport arhitectonic, o combinație multiplă de stiluri.
You can see here the Orthodox Metropolitan Cathedral, which was built between 1936 and 1940. Architect was Traianescu. The cathedral was painted between 1939 and 1946, and I can say that the total height of it is 90 meters. During the services, in the interior can come almost 5,000 people.
Celebrul Castel Huniade, zidit de către Ioan Huniade în anii 1443-1448, pe locul unde fusese Palatul Regal al lui Carol Robert de Anjou, un edificiu despre care știm că a fost mai apoi între anii 1552-1716 reședința autorităților romane, otomane, cazarmă de artilerie și arsenal până după cel de-al doilea război mondial și în final sediu al Muzeului Banatului.
You can see here the Hunyadi Castle, which was built by Ioan Hunyadi, from 1443 till 1448 on the site of the former royal castle of Charles Robert of Anjou. Later, it was an official residence of the Ottoman authorities, then artillery barracks, then arsenal, and now it became a museum.
La nord de Piața Victoriei, străbătând o străduță îngustă, ajungem în piața primăriei vechi, acum numită Piața Libertății. Construită în decursul primei jumătăți a secolului XVIII, pe locul fostului bazar din perioada turcească, a jucat rolul centrului administrativ al orașului, în piață aflându-se principalele clădiri ale administrației civile și militare din epocă. Aici vedem profilurile robuste ale edificiilor militare, fosta casă a generalului, zidită în anul 1723 și refăcută în repetate rânduri prin anii 1728, 1788, 1860, apoi remodelată pe la 1900, acum sediul cazinoului militar, și alături cazarma nouă a diviziei, ridicată cam tot în aceeași perioadă. În fața lor străjuiesc încă cele două tunuri de fier din ultimul război mondial și monumentul regelui Dac, ridicat în 1977. Este regele Decebal.
In the left part you can see the square, the Liberty Square and Piața Libertății, and it was built in the first half of the 18th century on the site of the former Turkish Bazaar. It has played a central role in the life of the city since the main buildings of the civil and military administration was traditionally located here. You can see here the military casino. You can see also two iron cannon from the last World War and the monument of the Dacian king Decebal.
Cea mai mare piață istorică a Timișoarei datează încă din anul 1733. Piața Unirii, odinioară numită Domplatz sau Piața Losonții, a reprezentat inițial centrul burghez al cetății și a fost restaurată în întregul său între 1980-1982. Geometric concepută, piața este flancată de un impunător ansamblu arhitectonic, unde jocul volumelor și asimetria clădirilor încadrează un spațiu de circa 150 de metri. Ajuns și aici, de la bun început, suntem atrași de muzica de orgă ce izvorăște dintr-o impunătoare clădire în stil baroc, Catedrala Romano-Catolică sau Biserica Episcopală Romano-Catolică sau Domul, așa cum este numită simplu de locuitorii orașului.
You can see here the Union Square, which dates from 1733. Initially represented the bourgeois center of the citadel, and it was completely restored between 1980 and 1982. The square is bounded by an imposing ensemble of buildings, and the area is approximately 150 by 100 meters. You can see there in the right part the Roman Catholic Cathedral Dome.
Latura sudică a acestei piețe este marcată de clădirea monumentală a Muzeului de Artă. Acest edificiu, cunoscut înainte sub numele de Palat Baroc, adăpostea prin 1733 clădirea oficiului minier și casieria militară, menționată la 2 ani după prima și extinsă în 1754. cu fațada remodelată în anul 1886 și în această clipă când o privim aproape cu totul restaurată, uriașa clădire barocă, numită inițial Clădirea Guvernatorului, între 1754-1819, apoi peste timp a vechii prefecturi, între 1919-1943, a avut destinații dintre cele mai diverse.
You can see here the art museum, which was called in the past the Baroque Palace, and it was built in 1733. It has different destinations, and you can see its front part, the facade, was remodelated in 1886, and now it is almost complete restoration.
Pe aceeași parte cu Palatul Baroc se află clădirea fostului Han la Elefant, înălțată înainte de 1746 și remodelată în mai multe rânduri. Ea se învecinează cu o clădire construită în stil secesion abia la începutul anilor 1900. La parterul lor funcționează astăzi mici restaurante și o veche farmacie. Casa Bruc este o clădire din Piața Unirii din Timișoara, un edificiu construit în 1910 după planurile arhitectului Laszlo Székely, în stilurile Art Nouveau și Secession, cu un caracter ușor eclectic.
You can see here in the left side the Inn, Elephant Inn, which was built in 1746 and restructured several times. And then it, in the right part is the Brook House, which was built in 1910 according to the plans of the architect Laszlo Székely in the Art Nouveau and Secession styles with a slightly eclectic character.
Printre toate aceste sclipiri ale trecutului, a traversat timpul grupul statuar sculptat în gresie al monumentului care reprezintă figurile Fecioarei Maria, Sfântului Ioan Nepomuc, patronul catolicilor din Banat, Sfântului Sebastian cu săgeți înfipte în piept și a Sfântului Rochus rănit la picior. Pe soclul monumentului Sfintei Treim se văd aspecte care înfățișează simbolic scene din timpul epidemiei de ciumă. La mică distanță de monument, suntem îndemnați să coborâm câteva trepte și să gustăm din apa minerală care țâșnește continuu din izvorul forat în 1894. De la o adâncime de 412 metri, apa minerală carbogazoasă și tămăduitoare aduce timișorenilor prilejul de a vizita și întâlni această piață a împăcării, credințelor și multietnicității orașului.
You can see here in the left part the Holy Trinity Monument, which symbolizes the representation in the time of plague. In the right part, you can see here the mineral water fountain, which was drilled in 1894. And the deep is around 400 meters. And the people are gathering in this Union Square to drink these curative properties mineral water in this place.
În imagine observăm canalul Bega. Lucrările de amenajare ale acestui canal au fost începute în anul 1728 și finalizate în 1775.
You can see here the channel of the Bega River, and the works for the arrangements of this channel was started in 1728 and was completed in 1775.
Fabrica de bere Timișoreana este prima fabrică de bere din România, înființată în 1718, iar o parte a vechii fabrici se mai păstrează și astăzi. Aici, în grădina fabricii, în noiembrie 1847, Johann Strauss, compozitorul austriac, fiul, împreună cu orchestra sa, a susținut un concert în care a interpretat valsuri celebre precum Dunărea Albastră, Viața de artist, Sânge vienez sau Vin, femei și cântec. Acesta a fost primul concert susținut de Johann Strauss fiul în afara Vienei. În Timișoara, pe 12 noiembrie în 1884, au fost aprinse 731 de lămpi electrice, ceea ce a reprezentat o premieră în Europa, lucru care a transformat orașul de pe Bega în primul oraș iluminat electric din Europa. Timișoara se dezvoltă, apar noi cartiere, are o viață economică, socială, culturală deosebit de dezvoltată, fiind denumită Mica Vienne.
You can see in the left side is the Timișorana Brewery, which was the first brewery in Romania, founded in 1718. And a part of this old factory is still preserved today. Here in the factory garden in November 1847, the Austrian composer Johann Strauss, the son, together with his orchestra, held a concert in which he performed famous voices. This was the first concert given by Johann Strauss, the son, outside Vienna. In the right side, you can see that in November 1884, 731 electric lamps were lit, which was a premiere in Europe, which transformed the city of Nebega into the first electric lighting city in Europe.
Complexul Bastion a rămas o proiecție vie a ceea ce a ființat odată ca înlănțuirea cazărmii. Din cele 9 bastioane existente în 1733, Bastionul Terezia, singurul păstrat parțial, formează acum una dintre cele mai pitorești zone ale orașului, adăpostind sub bolțile sale deschise pasaje, restaurante și baruri, galerii de artă și spații expoziționale. Acoperișul unui tronson în anul 1908, supraînălțat ulterior în stil baroc, găzduiește o secție etnografică a Muzeului Banatului cu o bogată colecție de artă populară.
You can see here the Bastion complex, which is still a living remnant of what once existed as a defensive curtain around the barracks. Terezia Bastion was erected in 1733 and represents one of the most picturesque areas of the city. Its walls have been opened up to accommodate passages, restaurants and bars, art galleries and exhibition hall.
Colegiul Național Pedagogic din Timișoara, construit în stil neogotic englez victorian, după planurile arhitecților Jacob Klein din Timișoara și Leopold Baumhorn din Budapesta, între anii 1902-1903, a fost denumit după pseudonimul literar al primei regine a României, Carmen Silva. Este una dintre școlile de elită ale țării.
You can see here the National Pedagogical High School Carmen Silva in Timișoara. It was named after the literary pseudonym of the first queen of Romania, Carmen Silva. The building was built in Victorian Neo-Gothic style between 1902 and 1903. It is one of the country's elite school, and I can tell you that Mirela Carp is a teacher in that high school.
La fel și fiica dumneavoastră.
And also my girl studied at this high school.
Și suntem mândre de acest lucru. Și iată, mai mult ca și oricând, odată cu venirea primăverii, întregul oraș înflorește, confirmând prin botezul a generații de grădinari numele de oraș al florilor.
And you can see here, Timișoara is a city of flowers.
Iulius Town, orașul din centrul Timișoarei, este un proiect de regenerare urbană gândit pentru a coagula comunitatea și pentru a aduce la oaltă pe toți, indiferent dacă vin la birou, la cumpărături sau pentru a face sport, ori să se relaxeze. Iulius Town este un oraș în inima Timișoarei, un spațiu efervescent, deschis spre multiculturalitate, care oferă energie și printr-o agendă bogată de evenimente variate pentru toate categoriile de public, de la activități educative și recreative pentru copii, manifestări culturale și competiții sportive, până la târguri tematice, festivaluri și expoziții de artă.
You can see here Iulus Town, which is a city in the center of Timișoara, an urban regeneration project designed to coagulate the community and bring everyone together, whether they come to the office, shopping, playing sports, or relaxing. Iulus Town is a city in the heart of Timișoara, a space which offers energy and a rich agenda of various events for all audiences, from educational and recreational activities for children, cultural events and sport competition, themed fairs, festival, and art exhibition.
Aceasta a fost prezentarea noastră. Mulțumim!
This was the presentation and we thank you very much and we are welcome you to see in physic, in person, the city of Timișoara. We are welcome you when it is possible. We wait for you here.
Just have a look at the presenters because we didn't see them.
Ne trebuie să ne sme zdravi, da imame vaccinația și da dojde. Opa, sorry. We hope to be in good health, to have got vaccination and to visit Timișoara with pleasure. So the people there are very nice, so it will be real pleasure for us. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mirela, for preparing this presentation and Anna for translating.
For this hard work, thank you very much.
Thank you.
So now we continue with Bulgarian song. This song will be from the singer Yordanka Ilieva and Orchestra Horor Ruse. Three evening on the Danube. Because Yordanka is afraid to be real participant in our conference. So for this reason, I will present her and the orchestra for very shortly. So she is the singer, this is the orchestra, Choro Ruse. Choro, it means dance, special dance. She made these pictures especially for you and with her friends in the Wista to wish you health and happiness. She won many prizes. She was awarded the title The Voice of the Folklore Source 2014 for exceptional vocal skills in the performance of Bulgarian folklore. On this picture, she is on the left. The Orchestra Choro was established in 1962 by Vasil Parvanov as a part of dance group Naiden Kirov, Ruse. Sometimes I have to present maybe this dance group, which is very famous. Now the leader is Lyubomir Christov, but the member Cvetan Banev was a member of our video conferences with his guitar. During this period, the orchestra has created more than 500 dances and songs. It has participated in many festivals in France, Japan, Italy, and many, many countries. The orchestra was awarded many prizes. For example, the first prize of the biggest world folk festival, Songs and Dances of the World in Paris, 1999. What is the content of the song? A girl sings, my beloved, I waited for you three evenings on the River Danube. Why didn't you come? Did you lose your horse? Don't you love me anymore? My mother has heard bad words about you. Is it true that you are lying to me? Does another woman listen to your words? When the moon appears, I will leave. The water of the Danube becomes muddy. The girl's is like a bouquet of flowers. It is beautiful in the morning and wither in the evening. So let's hear this very dynamic song. Continue with very interesting presentation. This is Tarlisu and Bumbasina. The Triangle of Culture, Economy and Arts, a presentation of Farnas Tayershems from Federuni.
Tarlisu and Bumbasina. The Triangle of Culture, Economy and Art. Presented by Federini Iteca. Let's have a look to the historical origin of the traditional carnival masks in Italy. The Italian tradition, according to which masks are worn at carnival, has its roots in a truly ancient past. In fact, with the Dante comedy, the mask acquired a certain dignity, conquering the theater and becoming a sort of caricature character. This is how the Italian masks were born and became a form of art in all respects. Characters who don't follow a script, but a rough canvas seasoned with skin, passion, and hard-working spirit. Among all these iconic Italian masks, we choose the ones from Busto Arsizio, the famous textile city. Let's have a look to the geographical position of Busto Arsizio. Busto Arsizio is an Italian city in the southeastern part of the province of Varese, in the region of Lombardy, in northern Italy. 35 Lombard north of Milan. After the Second World War began a series of increasingly important initiatives aimed at rediscovering local traditions. And from there, the Bustoki mask came back to life. Tarlizu and his fresh bride Bombazina are two puppets that embody the carnival of Busto Arsizio. Tarlizu is a male figure, taken its name from a type of early 19th century fabric, invented by Bustoki and used as a mattress cover. This fabric was remarkably successful and exported all over the world. The success gave a strong impetus to the development of the textile industry in Busto Arsizio, so much so that the city deserved, in those glorious times, the nickname of Manchester of Italy. At that time, Tarlizu was the official mascot of the fabric, which exclusively produced in Busto Arsizio. Instead, the same mask, Bombazina, joined Tarlizu 21 years later, forming the ideal couple of the textile reality of the city. The Bombazina was a raw cotton cloth used mainly as sheets, but also to make towels and aprons for the household. One of the characteristics of this fabric was that all the preparation of the yarn was done manually, and therefore is an artisanal way. Consequently, the Bombazina presented in the piece what in Busto was called a guzzetta, which is residue of the shell of the cattle. In this way, the Tarlizu and Bombazina had all the characteristics to be the symbol of the textile city and can therefore be proclaimed as such to present the cultural and folkloristic heritage and to remember and celebrate the seed that gave rise to the industrial and economic development of Busto Arsizio. For this part, we provide you a piece of carnival movie. Let's watch it together.
Where are you from, Tarlizu? Assumo un italiano. A me città le busti, cale la visia a Milano.
A fermo tu, Tarlizu?
A gano chi un papui, a voi ti e chi va, ti e noci pim pum pan. E con i bastimenti di là dal mare, insieme agli emigranti, lui stesso volle andare. Parte bar del Tarlizu, che prezzi e qualità, i ripete a mie genti che in America che alò.
The creator of modern mask was Giovanni Sacanago, the patron of the Busto Carnival, who died in 2013. Now it's time for the sweetest part of the carnival, carnival sweets. The typical carnival sweet is chiacchiere, which means chatting. the crunchy sugar-coated bread. Castagnone is another famous carnival sweet. They are soft sugar-coated balls prepared with a dough made from flour, butter, sugar, milk, and eggs, often with the addition of aromas or liquor, stuffed with shanty cream or chocolate. And then, special thanks to Ginetto Luigi that has preserved local tradition. Alexico Grave, who has an EAC make a new spring bloom to the historical dialect. With this slide, we reach to the end of the presentation. Thank you all for your time.
Oh, Farnaz, thank you very much for this beautiful presentation with so many facts from the past and real beautiful music. We can feel Italians.
It's a great pleasure for us. It can be a matter of interest for you.
Okay, thank you very much. Dear colleagues, I would like to remark that these presentations are very beautiful and person work very hard to develop them day and to present for us on that conference. We continue with very beautiful song from Serbia. Tatjana Petrica from Vršac, Serbia. We'll present the song I Grow Up Along the Danube of Zvonko Bogdan. So, Tatjana, welcome. Era di te o petro di o
Pela odissura ma corazzo fragile di mamma odio Pela odissura ma corazzo fragile di mamma odio Duna ve duna tra i pedemi che se non è stato Duna ve, duna ve, tra i pedemi che se non è stato Tra i pedemi che se non è stato
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Tatiana.
Bravo, bravo, very good rhythm. This evening, all singers are perfect. So, Vicky, can we continue?
Yes, we have one contribution left.
Okay.
Yes, we have a guest who have followed us from the very, very beginning. It's Larry Nyoku, a friend of ours and also a Danube networker, even though he's from Nigeria, no, not from a Danube country, but with the heart and with the soul with us. And we're very glad that he is performing today a song, a guitar song. So Larry, maybe you can say a couple of words. The song is Angel of the Morning.
Larry? Even now is the night, angel in the night. Please sing your nice, beautiful thing, song.
Well, yes, hi. Thank you, Victoria, for those nice words. Yes, so as Victoria said, it's the song that I'll be performing is Angel of the Morning. It's originally by Chip Taylor, but lots of people, they've recorded it over the years, and the most famous is by James Newton, which I'm certain that some of us know from this rendition of the song. So I will be playing like a version of this. Yeah, and so I am not a professional. Like we had a very good performance. We have seen some good performances today, and these are really, really good as compared to me. So just know, keep this in mind. Okay. There'll be no strings to bind your hands, but if my love can bind your heart, and there's no need to take a stand, for it was I who chose to start. I see no need to take me home, 'cause I'm old enough to face the dawn. Just call me Angel of the Morning, Angel, just hold my cheek before you leave me, baby. Just call me Angel of the Morning, Angel. Then slowly turn away from me. The sunlights will be dim, but it won't matter
It was beautiful. It was beautiful, very melancholic, and very romantic. Great, great song, a great ending of the evening. So thank you very, very much. And it's time to say goodbye. Yes, I hope you liked the evening. And I just put in spotlight everybody who prepared this evening. And one important thing to let you know for the next time that we start later, half an hour later at 6:30. So to give you time to enjoy a little bit the summer that is starting right now. So 6:30 German time, we see you and we will see each other on the 13th of May.
Yeah, this is important, and we invite you to take part, to be good actors, to be together with us on 3rd of May.
On the 13th of May, yes.
Thank you very much to all of you. And Carmen, do you like to...
Yeah, bye-bye. It was a very nice evening, and thank you for all actors, but also for all those who had been in. And we make the next session in 3 weeks, not in two, because there is Pentecosta in Bulgarian.
I don't know this celebration. Svetla, do you know it?
Pfingsten.
Pentecosta
in Italiano. And anyway, for this reason, we will meet at the end of May, and we are very happy to see you again and bring with you other friends. Thank you.
Thank you, friends, and bye-bye.